Okay, everybody, this is Thomas Was Alone. It's a nice little platformer puzzle game. And I played it before. It's an awesome game, and I'm happy it's on the PS4. Without saying too much, let's go to a new game.
Was alone. Wow, a weird first thought to have. Thomas decided to start listing his observations for posterity. 1. The whole alone thing. 2. Portals. They led somewhere. He'd yet to work out where. 3. Falling. Thomas was absolutely fantastic at falling. He was almost as good at falling as he was at observing. Okay, interesting. Thomas couldn't fall past this block. Think, damn it, think. What if there was some kind of inverted fall? Some way to... what's the word? Jump. It worked! Thomas had solved the great inverted fall mystery. A big jump. But Thomas noted there was no real danger in missing it. The world didn't want him to fail here. It was pushing him, but gently. This all seemed a little dangerous. The world was not to be trusted. It was unstable, and it seemed to Thomas that it could let him down at any moment. Thomas wondered whether the portals were actually taking him anywhere. He felt like he was making progress, but there wasn't really any way to know. He seemed to be moving predominantly up and to the right, which might, or might not, be important. It might have been paranoia again, but Thomas could have sworn the world was becoming more complicated. It always seemed to be one step ahead of his skills. It had been designed just for him. He wondered why. Was the world testing him? No, too obvious. Something about the boiling, toxic, glowing water intimidated Thomas. He didn't like it. He certainly didn't want to swim in it. He made another mental note. 4. Water. Not good. To be avoided. The loneliness was getting to Thomas. No amount of observation or obsessive note-taking could combat that.
Excuse me.
Had a new theory. The world was training him. He could feel himself getting smarter. There was the mental list to consider. Over the minutes and seconds since his spontaneous generation, he'd become a pretty skilled jumper, was evolving. He just wished he had someone to share it with. Chris took an immediate and deep dislike to the skinny red rectangle. Who the hell did this Thomas think he was? Chris had been doing fine. He wasn't the highest jumper, but he'd held his own. He'd even been graceful at times. Well, not actually. Not technically graceful. It's probably the wrong word, but, you know, fine. There was that skinny little runt leaping about like he owned the place.
God, Chris. Chris is a jerk. It's almost all over.
Was more like it. A glowy white thing. Only Chris could get to it, which of course made it all the more enticing. What would it do? What new opportunity might this switch open up to him? Grace. Another chance for Thomas to jump slightly higher than Chris. How fortunate. Seriously, this made the whole switch-pressing thing entirely worthwhile. Was this good? Because on the surface, it did not seem good. Chris was pretty scared. Little Red seemed fine, happy to be on his merry little adventure. Chris couldn't shake the feeling that things had taken a significant turn for the worse since Thomas had joined him. Sure, he'd been able to piggyback his way to ever so slightly higher platforms, but where had that got him? Well, to ever so slightly higher platforms, which was sort of his point. Thank you.
Right, gonna leave that there for a moment. That was Thomas Was Alone. I'm probably gonna come back to this. I will come back to this. Probably, maybe the first playthrough. Probably, maybe. But yeah, that was Thomas Alone. It's a nice platformer puzzle game. It is absolutely awesome. It's got good humor about it. It's nice gameplay. Nice characters. Chris is a jerk, man. Thomas is awesome. I love how this game just give these really in-depth characters to triangles and squares and stuff, man. It's an awesome game. So yeah, this was Dave playing Thomas Was Alone.